Thank you. Good morning, Unity North. How about a little noise for the great music, yes? Isn't she lovely? Isn't he lovely? Aren't you lovely? Yes? Happy Thanksgiving week, everybody. It's a day of gratitude, and so we're going to have a little bit of extra music today to just get things going. And this first song is going to have a part for all of you. I'm just praying, thank you, God. Say that with me. I'm just praying, thank you, God. The only other part you have is goes like this, oh, yeah. Oh, yeah, I'm just praying, thank you, God. I'm going to invite Jeannie up here to sign. Let's kick this thing in. And if you feel led, please join your voice and your heart and your spirit with mine. We could pray for 100 things right now, but we're going to just pray gratitude, yes? Let's put some lyrics up there on the screen if we can. Well, I ain't praying for a new situation. I'm just praying, thank you, God. And I ain't praying for a new conversation. I'm just praying, thank you, God. So if I just don't like my current view, I look a different way and change my attitude. I ain't praying for a new conversation. I'm just praying, thank you, God. Oh, yeah, I'm just praying, thank you, God. That was your part. Now, I ain't praying for a new location. I'm just praying, thank you, God. And I ain't praying for a new vocation. I'm just praying, thank you, God. So when I'm feeling down, I'm feeling blue, I get down on my knees and find some gratitude. I ain't praying for a new vocation. I'm just praying, thank you. Here's your part. Oh, yeah. I'm just praying, thank you, God. If it's the only prayer I ever pray, well, I know that I will be okay. No matter what comes my way, thank you, God, is all I pray. Now, I ain't praying for a new direction. I'm just praying, thank you, God. And I ain't praying for some new medication. I'm just praying, thank you, God. So if I just don't like my current view, I look a different way and change my attitude. I ain't praying for some new medication. I'm just praying, thank you, God. I'm just praying, thank you, God. If that's the only prayer I ever pray, I'm there, I'm praying, thank you, God. And I ain't praying for this beautiful complexion. I'm just praying, thank you, God. So when I'm feeling down, I'm feeling blue, I get down on my knees and find some gratitude. I ain't praying to achieve perfection. I'm just praying, thank you, God. I'm just praying one more time. I'm just praying, thank you, God. Oh, yeah. We're praying, thank you, God, and thank you, God, doing business as Danielle. Give her a hand.
good morning, my friends, my family. Oh, we are going to take that energy and take that into prayer. I know we got really amped up in that, but we can get really amped up in prayer as well. We're going to close our eyes, but we're going to hold on to all of that goodness. As we say thank you, and we call to mind something that we are grateful for, and we say thank you. And we call to mind something else, and holding on to that same positive, energetic energy, we say thank you. And yet again, we call to mind something else we are thankful for, Let me say thank you. Thank you, God. Thank you, Spirit. Thank you, Creator. Thank you, Universe. Thank you for this opportunity to say thank you. One of many, many opportunities. As we keep our hearts and our minds open wide to gratitude, to love, to light, to our own divine light. And for all of those things and so much more, we say thank you. Thank you, and amen.
Thank you. Take a moment to look out these windows. Is this earth beautiful or what? Yes? We are so blessed. Take a moment to look inside your head. Are we blessed? Is it beautiful inside your head as well? Inside your heart? We're going to let you sing now. You were so good on the first song. We're going to let you have another one. This is a Ricky Byers song. My God is so good to me. God, by whatever name you want to give it, up on your feet. Let's get the place moving a little bit. And let's just realize that God is so good in, through, around, and expressed as all creation. I woke up this morning saying, God is so good. Come on now. I woke up this morning saying, God is so good. I woke up this morning saying, God is so good. My God is so good to me. Let's hear that again now. I woke up this morning. So grateful that you've tuned in. You are part of our family. You're a part of our experience, and we're so grateful that you've brought your energy into this space. Welcome. So good to me. Life is so good to me. Every day and every way. Every day. Every day and every way. Life is so good. Oh, every day and every way. Life is so good. Every day and every way. Life is so good. My life is so good. One more time from the beginning. I woke up this morning saying life. Amazing today. Please be seated.
Love that ending. So if you're ever wondering, is this church this full of energy and love and gratitude every single Sunday? The answer is yes, it is. Every single Sunday, it is full of love and energy and gratitude. And this Sunday is no different. Our welcome team is coming forward to welcome anyone who may be here for the first time. They have in their hands welcome packets. And in those welcome packets are Let's Connect cards, because we want to connect with you. So you can use pen and paper and fill them out and turn them in later. You can scan the QR code and fill it out digitally. And either way, Richard will wake you up with this song tomorrow morning to remind you that, Okay. He didn't actually agree to that. But we want you to fill the card out anyway. So right now, we are going to pour love on you. So if this is your first time here this Sunday, please raise your hand high in the air. Keep it up so we can get a packet to you while we express our thanks for you choosing Unity North on this beautiful Sunday. Keep your hands up high, and we promise to get a packet to you. Thank you so much for choosing Unity North this morning. All right, it is one of our favorite times in the service. It is? That's right, it's announcement time. We get to find out what is happening in this beautiful, vibrant community. So our first announcement is that this Wednesday, we're not having a cater dinner, but we are still having a potluck dinner. So what beautiful fragrant smells will be in the air? It all depends on what you bring this Wednesday at 6. So we still have meditation at 7 and a spiritual dialogue at 7:45. We'll have another potluck on Thursday as we celebrate Thanksgiving together. So 12:30 to 2:30, please make sure that you register if you are planning on attending. You can scan that QR code. You can go in the app for more information. It is a love offering of $10 per person or $25 per family, and a wonderful opportunity to just share space with each other. Our next announcement. Adopt a tree. So as we said last Sunday, the large trees are already adopted, but there's still space to adopt the small trees in memory of our loved ones. So we have until November 26th to sign up to adopt a tree. And then the unveiling, the magical, beautiful lights, I love lights if you can't tell, the magical, beautiful lights will be unveiled at our next announcement, which is about the service of remembrance. So on November 29th at 7 o'clock, right here in the sanctuary, we'll have a service of remembrance to honor our loved ones whose eternal light continues to shine on. And as we said in the last announcement, those trees become unveiled at this ceremony. So we've got a beautiful week extending into next week. So make sure that you check the app, check Facebook, get more information, and sign up for the things you want to sign up for. Before I turn it back over to Richard, I just want to thank our prayer chaplains on duty this morning, four beautiful souls seated around the sanctuary. Sarah, Nancy, Sharon, and John, thank you for sharing of your time and holding us all in sacred space, love, and gratitude this morning. And my gratitude goes to Richard and Jeannie for this next song.
You know, we are just wrapping up. Go ahead and clap for announcements. You're going to get to hear a lot more of Danielle today. Because I'm filling in doing some of the music today, I've asked Danielle to do the message with me. And let me tell you, to share space with that woman is a gift. You are a gift. We're wrapping up. Last 3 weeks, we had a big campaign. And there are going to be some announcements about how that campaign has brought more prosperity to Unity North. But this is an old song, I think, that I wrote about 25 years ago. And it seems appropriate to just talk about the principles that we have been working with and put it in one big bow on the top of it. And there's a part for all of you to sing, so the lyrics will be up there. When we get to that place, I invite you to sing along. Let's go ahead and kick this in. The band has been joking because it feels like Mustang Sally. There was a time I didn't like the word time. It made me squirm. It made me writhe. There was a time I didn't like the word service. It made me feel scared and awfully nervous. But then I learned about universal laws, like the one about effect and cause, the power of letting go, and never ever stopping God's flow. Now here is what I do. I want to share my secret with you. I have faith my Creator loves me. Every need, you see, here is is what I've found. There's enough good to go around. Here is what I know. What I reap is what I sow. As I give, I receive. God never stops blessing me. So let the celebration start.
It off in 20 more years from now, but I appreciate you playing. I'm going to turn this off and put the headset mic on so I can get rid of this out of my hand. Are we good?
Can you hear me? Can you hear me now? We're good. So I want to start with a quote as the foundation of everything that Danielle and I are going to talk about today. It's from Joanna Macy. She's a philosopher and she's an earth activist. She's really, really concerned about saving the planet for our grandkids and our great-grandkids. Let's read this together. We have received an inestimable gift to be alive in this beautiful, self-organizing universe, to participate in the dance of life, with senses to perceive it, lungs that breathe it, organs that draw nourishment from it, is a wonder beyond words. I wanted, before we get into this message, to take a moment to go, we are so blessed. And I think sometimes in this world, we go around walking unconsciously, we're not paying attention, and we're looking at what isn't working in the world, but I think not just on Thanksgiving, but every Sunday, every Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, we need to stop and go, wow. Do that with me. Wow. I am blessed. Say that with me. And those are not just three words, I am blessed. Oh, it's compulsory. The minister asked me to do it. I'm asking you to get in touch with what those words represent. They represent a consciousness, a human being that says, I will not be defined by what's happening in the world, but what's happening on the inside, right here. An awareness and a consciousness that has the eyes to see the good, the ears to hear the good, the heart to call the good out when nobody else can find it. Yes, that is our job. That is our job. How many people here got in a car and got transportation to be here today? You are blessed. How many of you had a roof over your head last night, a place to sleep? You are blessed. How many of you had something to eat this morning? You're amongst the top 5%. Like a little change in your pocket. You got some money in your pocket. Hopefully a little bit less after you leave. No. No, hopefully you're more rich and prosperous in mind and heart and in wallet when you leave here today. But you're amongst the top 5% of wealthy people on the planet if you've got a car, a house, and food to eat. And look around. You have family. You have friends. You have community. A safe place to come and go, wow. Do it one more time with me. Wow. Within that wow is the awareness that we can change the world, that we have the ability to change the world. The wow is not a compulsory something I just ask you to do. It is in a sense of awe and wonder. We must become like children to enter that kingdom of awareness in heaven. That means going wow every morning when you get up. Thank you, God. Thank you, One. Thank you, Earth. Thank you, Yvonne. Thank you, Ray. Thank you to everybody. There's power in the wow. There's power in the thank you, whatever you thank. It is creative. Today and all week long, let us not just be in thanksgiving. I'm asking you to be proactive and be in thanks choosing. To be in thanks choosing this whole week and maybe set a new pattern and direction for your life that the whole year, rest of the year, is a place of choice. We simply cannot wait until everything is perfect to practice gratitude. Oh, it's Thanksgiving, now I'll be grateful. Too late. It's too late. We're all waiting around for the perfect moment, for the darkness in the world to stop, for people to suddenly behave the way I think they're supposed to behave. Then I will be grateful. Then you've given all the power to what's out here. All the power resides in here, but you've given it away. It cannot be taken from you, but you can give it away. Yes? We're all waiting around till everything lines up perfectly. We're content and secure. Let me tell you, we have a spiritual bank account. And if you're waiting until everything is perfect to make a deposit, too late. Anybody live your life like that? I did for a portion of my life. Things suddenly fell apart and they weren't working. Then I'm on my knees. Oh, let me say thank you, God. Let me thank you. Not too late. It's too late. There was no bank account to pull from. Anybody try to go to the bank and make a withdrawal without having made a deposit for the last 3 years? The bank doesn't play that, and neither do spiritual principles and laws. When we make those regular deposits every morning, every evening, and every minute in between, there's something to draw from when the world falls apart. There's something to pull from because you have been a regular spiritual practitioner, not just a hobbyist. Gratitude is not a hobby. It cannot be an event. Gratitude must be a way of life. Yes? We're going to explore different aspects of gratitude in one, and I'm going to ask Danielle to speak about this in a minute, but I found this quote by Diana Butler Bass, and it was a whole way of thinking of gratitude that I'd never thought of before. Can you read that up there? Is it legible? Let's read it together. To be grateful in these days is an act of resistance, of resilience, of renewal. And I'm going to add to that. Gratitude is an act of rebellion. Gratitude is an act of revolution. And we're going around complaining. There's war everywhere on the planet. People are dying. Children are losing their life. What if gratitude was not a Pollyanna attitude to pretend it's not happening, but to say, I won't play the game of hate. I will find some light in the midst of the darkness. I will no longer play the game the world wants to play by making enemies and creating duality. I will be grateful for the people that are right in front of me as an act of rebellion. I don't play that game anymore. Go ahead and clap. Don't do it halfway. Gratitude is another way in which we can proclaim our defiance to what is happening in the world today. Defiance. Boy, that takes it to a whole different dimension, doesn't it? Revolution and rebellion, another way we can express our unwillingness to be defined by the conditions of the world, to be the change we want to see, another way to show our commitment to a future that is way brighter, that is way more just, more equitable, and more fair, more beautiful, more holy, more everything. And so I can't think of another person to share about this. The lady to my left is changing the planet, not just here at Unity North, her work. She is making sure that old paradigms are dying, that old paradigms and belief systems no longer dot the landscape, but she's never once lost her capacity for grace, her capacity for gratitude, her capacity for light as she is calling out that which needs to be called out. So I'm going to ask her to share a little bit about this idea that we just shared.
Thank you. Thank you.
So when I was thinking about gratitude as resistance, as resilience, as renewal, Spirit put a pretty powerful word on my heart. So powerful that I went back to Spirit and said, are you sure that's what you want me to stand on the platform and say? And Spirit said, yes. So here we go. So when I think about gratitude in these three forms, I think about the word privilege. And I know that makes some people itch, it makes some people feel a way in their bodies, and that's okay. But when I think about privilege, I don't think about it as some people having it and some people don't. I think about the gratitude for having privilege so that you can use it for positive purposes, right? I have privilege. I'm a Black woman in this country. I still have privilege, and I use that privilege as resistance to systems of oppressions that exist. And I'm grateful for that privilege and the ability to be able to use it. So my challenge today is to ask you to think about privilege not in a way that you lean into the fear of that word, but lean into gratitude for having whatever form of it that you can to break down systems of oppression so that there is more justice in this world. And if you call yourself a peacemaker and you're thinking about peace on earth and peace on this planet, you have to remember there is no peace without justice. And we can use our privilege to get more justice for those identities, for those marginalized identities that don't currently have them. We can do that by being grateful for that word, by leaning into that and resisting fear.
If I don't use my privilege as a white male for good to elicit change, I have wasted that privilege. And I can be defensive about saying I have privilege, or I can go, yes, I do have some privilege, and I'm going to make the world a better place. If Danielle can stand here and claim her privilege as an American, I can stand here as a white male, an American, claim that privilege too, and then use whatever blessing or opportunity I've ever had to make her world a better place, to make your world a better place, to make the entire planet a better place. And yes, it's uncomfortable, but let me tell you, gratitude sometimes will put you at the level of comfortable, of uncomfortable. And I'm really grateful that I've grown up in an environment that allows me to have a voice, and a voice to use that voice for the highest and best. The real spiritual discipline of thanks choosing is not to ignore the pain and the suffering in the world and pretend it's not happening, but to fully acknowledge it, to work and to use my blessings and benefit to alleviate that suffering and yet still give thanks. It is to find reason for gratitude even in the pain, even in the chaos. It is to look deeper into the fabric of our world and see blessings where nobody else can find them, and to be them where nobody else is being them. For me, true thanksgiving is actually born of hardship. There are two things that absolutely define my life and the privilege that I've had, and I invite you to think the same way. Two things. Number one was the moments I was brought to my knees. Some of you had more privilege than I did. I grew up as a poor country boy. But the hardships made me the man I am today. The hardships that I pulled myself up because my grandparents taught me to do so, buy your bootstraps and don't be defined by the lack of a bank account, make a deposit, even if it's 10 cents. Pull yourself up. It was the dark nights of the soul where I found a greater capacity to be me, a greater capacity to shine my light, but it must be partnered. The other thing my grandparents taught me was when you're down on your knees and you're suffering, find something to praise. Find somebody to praise. Find something in your life to water the garden of that gratitude, because that's what's going to grow. I stand here today as, yes, somebody who had privilege, and yes, somebody who watered more privileges down the line. Danielle has created a life for herself because she did exactly the same thing, and I know the stories in this room. You watered something more holy, more sacred, more beautiful in your life than the circumstance. That's what gratitude does. Yes? This is what we read in Scripture. Paul's letter, I don't quote Paul very often because I think he's a crackpot and was on drugs. But occasionally, in a drug-induced moment, good things have come out. Not that I know that personally. But he wrote this in his first letter to the people of Thessalonica. In everything, give thanks. In everything. He didn't say, do it sometimes. Do it when it feels good. He didn't say once in a while or once a year on Thanksgiving or on Sunday when you're feeling holy and sacred. No, he said, in everything, give thanks, the good, the bad, and the ugly. Sarah's going to sing a song a little bit later of Morissette. What's her name? Alanis Morissette, who went to India and had some pretty wonderful experiences and some pretty not so wonderful experiences. And she calls it all out. Let's give thanks for all of it. Is it possible that we could get to the consciousness where we give thanks for everything? I believe it's possible. And I would be completely and totally remiss on this Thanksgiving weekend to not mention the indigenous people of this nation and this country. Their view of Thanksgiving is slightly different than my white male privileged Thanksgiving. Not in a place of condemnation, but a place of recognition. The people of the earth have a very different version of this story that we've told over and over and over again. Yet, when it comes to their spirituality, the people of the earth, they've never wavered on their ability to thank the Great Spirit, to thank the earth, to be grateful people no matter what, despite the betrayal, the difficulties, the hardships, and the rewritten history. These people are still able to find reasons to say, thank you, Great Spirit. Their challenges are far less than anything I've ever had to experience. And so I think we would be remiss to not take a moment on this Thanksgiving week in the silence to just give thanks. Put the next slide up there. Let's take a moment to honor the true history of the indigenous people of our nation who, despite it all, remain thankful for Great Spirit and the earthly home in the silence. Aho and amen. Today, Danielle and I are going to explore four dimensions of gratitude. Do you ever think of gratitude as having dimension? It does. It's far greater and bigger than anything we've ever pictured. We're going to explore the intensity of gratitude, the frequency of gratitude, the span, and the density of gratitude. Let's begin with the intensity. This is the strength and the power and the potency and the force of the emotion itself. Gratitude as an emotion. It can range from simple, compulsory, oh, you did something nice, I noticed, thank you, to overwhelming tears that come spontaneously. A sense of awe, a sense of wonder, a sense of, oh my gosh, how blessed am I. Anybody ever have those tears come where they are uncontrollable? You've got to feel. You've got to feel at depth. You know, we're about to head into this Advent season, and it's no accident that it comes through the divine feminine. On Thanksgiving, I want to feel what we need to feel. I want to allow ourselves, because emotion, gratitude takes us to the depth of emotion. I've done a lot of memorial services over this last year, and to a person, and it's usually the men, because the men have been told their whole life, don't feel, don't cry. I was told, go into your room if you have to cry and come out when you have it together. Thank God I'm hanging around people who say, wow, please cry. Let me into the sanctuary of your emotion and your feeling. The divine feminine can be birthed through you. But in these memorial services, these men, they say, I can't speak. There's one sitting here right now. I can't talk because I will lose it up here. I can't lose it publicly. And thank God I'm so blessed to be able to sit at the feet of men and women and to say, that's exactly what's needed. Come up here and publicly lose it. Because that is a portal. You see, you would not be grieving if there wasn't gratitude at depth there. You would not be grieving if there was not love at depth. My friend Ray, as an actor, says, you can follow every theater piece to love is somewhere. Even the worst behavior, love is there. Even in coming up here and going, I miss my beloved. I miss my child. Feel it. Those are the most sacred moments. A minister can get up here and share about theology, about that loss, and about the hereafter. That's all just words. The emotion is where the light will be born. The emotion and the tears. This is the intensity of gratitude. Let it overwhelm you. Let the gratitude for a person who touched you at depth be on display for the world to see, and do not make apology for the tears. There are people in this room whose lives have been changed by somebody else in this room. Go up and sob all over them and tell them thank you. Let the tears flow. I used to be, this is not just a theory for me. My family, I've talked about them enough time. I love my family, and we did not express emotion. That's what I was told. You're going to go cry, go in your room, and come out when you're better. I didn't know what God was. And so this Advent season that's coming is when I started hanging around theater people, people like Danielle, who told me, no, that's a sacrament. Tears are a sacrament. The realness of your hurt and your pain and your emotion is a sacrament. It's a sanctuary. Let it out. Those people were the theater people are the most free people on the planet. And let me tell you, I found God in the theater before I found God at home. And then I was introduced to a Unity Church where it's like, we're all a little bit odd. And the men cry here. And the women cry here. And we dance, and we're silly, and we're goofy, and we express the full range of emotion of being a human being because we experience the full range of our gratitude for each other, for life. I woke up this morning saying, life is so good. And that makes me want to cry. It makes me want to dance. It makes me want to sing. That's what I'm asking us to do this Thanksgiving, because your portal, your avenue to this thing we call God is going to come through the divine feminine, whether it be Mary, whether it be any woman in this place, or the divine feminine of your soul that says, here I am with all my emotions. Let me feel it. Second dimension, and I'm going to ask Danielle to come up here and talk about this, is the frequency of gratitude. Ever thought about that? Gratitude is not a one-time occurrence. Oh, it's Thanksgiving, now we're grateful. It's a state of mind. It's a state of living. It's a state of being. It's an energy that you carry around with you, a foundational state of being to growing and expanding. It's an intentional and purposeful commitment to having the eyes, the ears, and the heart to find good everywhere. Danielle has directed things on this stage where everything was falling apart, where no actor had learned their lines, where nobody was paying attention, yet this beautiful light of a being praised everybody on the stage, and she got out of them what she needed when they weren't showing up because she was grateful for them. She saw good where nobody else could find it, certainly not me.
So when my kids were younger, when they were tiny, they're 21 and 23 now, when they were tiny, I did not have reliable transportation. It was broken, I couldn't afford it, or whatever, you name it, that situation had happened. And so I was relying on bus service in a city that didn't have great bus service, and relying on the kindness of friends a lot. And I was very thankful for my friends, and I feel like they might not have known, I was really genuinely thankful to not have to walk in the rain or in the 100 degree heat. But I didn't tell myself, when I get a car, then I'm gonna be really even more thankful. But what ended up happening was, when I did get reliable transportation, every time I sat in my car, before I could put it in drive or reverse, I stopped and said thank you. It wasn't a promise I made to myself, it wasn't a promise I made to God. There was just this shift, there was this recognition of this gift, because I felt like I was playing small before. Like, I'm a grown-up and I don't have a car, I'm less than. What changed in me was not this thing, wasn't this material thing that I now had, but it was this daily act of gratitude, this daily act of stopping and just saying thank you to the universe for anything, for everything. But in that moment, it was just that change in my life. And so that frequency changed the way that I was able to look at the world. It changed the way that I walked in the world. And it wasn't the thing, but it was the thing in me.
So we're asking the question today, Is your gratitude circumstantial? Or is your gratitude relational? Big difference. Is your gratitude subject to the whims and the wills of the world? I have the car, so now I'm grateful. Or is it relational to what's on the inside? To what's going on the inside? Whether or not I have the car, I am grateful. And then Danielle has a very nice car right now. It's the same car that my wife drives. She got the car. What came first, the chicken or the egg? The gratitude or the car? So I'm asking you on this Thanksgiving, you want, you need. That's an energy that's keeping things away from you. Let's hold the energy. I'm grateful for what is right now, what is before me, the people that are before me. And if you're looking for a relationship, you think, I'll be grateful when that person shows up. No, be grateful for the people you're in relationship with right now. That is sexy. Gratitude is sexy and will attract that person to you. But if you're complaining and, oh, I can't meet anybody at church, they're all too old there. I went to the bar and they're all jerks there. That complaining is not attractive. I'm grateful for who's before me right now, regardless of their age, regardless of what they think, regardless of their political or religious bent. I'm just grateful that somebody beautiful is in front of me right now, and I don't have to agree on everything. The next dimension of gratitude is the span of gratitude. This is the number of things for which a person can be grateful for at the same time. Lots of people on this planet, you ask them, what are you grateful for? And they've got their top three. Oh, this, this, and this. No, keep going. And they're like, and they stammer. They stop. I'm asking you to create this Thanksgiving a 360 view of what there is to be grateful for. In fact, I want you to call it out right now. And you online, you call it out as well. What are you grateful for? Don't give me one or two. Give me 100. Go. Come on. Keep it up. Come on. What are you grateful for? Let that list expand 360 degrees. This Thanksgiving, I'm going to invite you to spend some time getting to the end of your list. Just let it be a brain dump. Boom, boom, boom. And eventually you're going to get to the place where it's like, I don't have anything else to say. That's the moment of growth. Find 10 more things to add to your list. 10 things that maybe are not necessarily, as the song is going to talk about, things that you think you should be grateful for. You know, my first moment here at Unity North, actually my first day working, I was the youth minister, and I went to the Uniteens program, middle school kids, and Will Hodge is our guitar player, and the first person I met on this campus was Amelia Hodge, his daughter, and I walked in there really unsure. I have no idea how to do this, but I really needed a job. And there was Amelia, Bryant, and one other kid, and his wife Carla were there, and we were going to do an art project. That before Amelia said hi to me, she came running to me, and she wrapped her arms around me, and she said, listen to this song. Listen to this song. And she put the headphones on me, and she goes, that's God. That's God. I said, yeah, that's beautiful. Who are you? And then I gave her the headphones back, and she says, no, wait, there's more. Listen to this song. And then she put on a piece of classical music, a middle school kid listening to classical music. And she said, listen to this. And she threw them on my ears, and she went, that's God too. And then we sat down and did an art project. And those of you who know me, I'm not much of an artist. Amelia was quite good, and she was putting together this stained glass piece of art, and I was putting together mine, and we were all doing it, and she says, look at how beautiful this is. She was encompassed. She was immersed in a state of it's all God. Her view was 360 degrees. And then we talked about her dad. I hadn't really met her dad yet. He's God too. And I've been dancing with Will for a while. I had to grow into that one. But she saw God everywhere. In fact, she became the teacher. She was the minister in that first day on this campus. She looked at my piece of art that wasn't nearly as good as hers, and she says, and that's God too. Where have I drawn the boundaries to where I find God? Where have I shut somebody out of my system of God? We don't have that wiggle room in Unity. And sometimes it's really difficult. And there was somebody first service that said, this person is creating evil on the planet. This person is doing violence on the planet. Can you be grateful for that which maybe has been forgotten? Can you dig beneath the surface to have the 360 view that somewhere at the corner of that person's mind they have forgotten? But there's still a light. There's still a goodness. I had this moment of the span of gratitude in my previous church. The church had started in July. And by November, the very first Thanksgiving, there were 400 to 500 people showing up for the Thanksgiving service. The choir was 80 strong. I had a band, a guy who had just had a stroke 2 months before who was learning to play the drums again. But in that, from July to November, it was a packed house. It was a small sanctuary, probably not as big as the middle of the room here. But there were people downstairs. There were people hanging. The tenor section was hanging on the piano. The soprano section was trying to dodge the drummer's hitting of the cymbal. And I was playing the piano, and we'd stomp on the floor. And the kids were in another room, and there was energy in the room. And I was overcome. It was God. And in that moment, I was grateful for the drummer. I was grateful for the singers. I was grateful for the ministers that started that. I was grateful for the sound tech in the back. I was grateful for the people who were out on the street praising God, not even in the room as we sang, in everything give thanks. In everything give thanks. The soloist was fabulous. But it wasn't about the soloist. It wasn't about who was up front. It was about everybody in the room. My span of gratitude was 360. This guy who's learning to play the drums again, I was as grateful for him as I was for the gospel soloist that was knocking the roof off the place. I was as grateful for the guy that was singing tenor, leaning on the piano, completely out of tune, on a wholly, totally wrong note, who was in bliss and joy, as grateful for him as I was to have that job. I'm asking you to expand your view of where gratitude can heal. Of where gratitude can uplift, where gratitude can save, and where gratitude can change the face of the planet, because it's all God. All of it. Even the works of art that maybe don't look like works of art. Finally, the density of gratitude. Awareness of the number of people that have been involved in the good as you sit down at a Thanksgiving meal. My family, it drives them nuts when I do this. Let's take a moment to think about the person who planted the seed in the soil in California so that food could be on my plate today. Okay, yeah, Dad, yeah. But what about the person who tilled and watered the soil, the earth? Let's be grateful for that person, the migrant worker that picked this food so that it could get to my plate. What about the animals that gave their life to be on this plate right now? What about the people who trucked it? Yeah, Dad. I'm not going to let the yeah-yeah-yeahs of my kids or my grandkids get in the way of having that density. We belong to each other, folks. That's just not a theory. You are. Ubuntu. You are because I am because you are. We belong to each other. I'm going to ask this beautiful lady to share one more story about this idea.
So connecting to what Richard said, there's this book, Teach, Breathe, Learn, that gave me an idea. And so I said before, so I'm a teacher. So think back to COVID. I know it feels so long ago and sometimes just like yesterday.
It was just 2 weeks ago.
Or just last week.
I'm still getting over it.
And you're doing wonderful. We're glad you're back. And so we were in the midst of online learning. And my third graders were learning about social emotional learning and the human body system at the same time. And so I had this idea from this book that we would do a lesson on mindful eating. So I had every kid just bring whatever snack they were going to eat after class, still in their jammies, because, you know, we're online. And we talked about what it took for that piece of whatever, that orange, to get there. And so someone would say, well, Mom just brought me my snack because you asked me to. Okay, cool. But how did it get to your house? Oh, I think Grandma went to the store and that's how it got to the house. Okay, but how did it get to the shelf? Well, I guess someone that worked there had to put it on the shelf. Okay, and how did it get to the store? And so forth and so forth, all the way back to someone planted that tree in that grove, someone tends to that soil. And so we thought about all the many hands and the many souls that are involved in every little thing that we're doing, but specifically in this snack, because, you know, they're eight. So framing it in that way that they could understand that it wasn't just one person that was involved in getting that snack to them. And then we ate. But we didn't just eat and talk. I didn't ask them to think about anything. Just savor the food. Just pause and eat what is in front of you without multitasking, without having conversation. And I've done this with 5-year-olds, done it with 12-year-olds. And at that time, I hadn't done it myself yet, so I didn't really know what the answer was at the end of the lesson. But almost every child that paused and ate thoughtfully and thankfully said they tasted a flavor that they hadn't tasted before. There was something different, something juicier, something sweeter in whatever it was that they were eating. And because they were being thankful and thoughtful and in this present moment, they were able to taste all of that. And so that density of gratitude, that recognition that there is nothing that is just one person, that density of people that we can be grateful for, the density of circumstances that lead us to this now moment, if we just pause and remember.
So our job on this Thanksgiving is, I want you to reflect about your spiritual community. Look around the room. You know, there are those of us that get to come on here and be on camera and be in front of you, people that get to sing, people who are up front. But this community is here because of the people that were behind the scenes. The people who don't get applause, attaboy, way to go. They also don't get the, that was a bad talk or it was a bad song. They don't get the judgment, but we stand on their shoulders, and I want you to reflect upon that, to this thanks-choosing season, to be aware that we have names on the wall who built buildings, but there are people who showed up, put their $5 in the plate, their $10 in the plate, people who said and sang the song, take my hands and use them. Send your children. I won't refuse them. Here's my heart. Here's my love. Here's my soul. Tell me where you want me to go. This is not a personality-centric ministry. This is a community-centric ministry. And everybody in this room, whether you're here for the first time or you're here for the last 30 years before any of us got here, you matter. You're important. And on this Thanksgiving, I want to say how humbled I am to be in your company. How humbled I am for the opportunities I get to stand up here and to speak. You're all a part of my privilege. You're all a part of Danielle's privilege. And I hope that we're a small part of your privilege and that each of us uses that privilege with intensity, with frequency, span, and density of gratitude so profound that a new awareness, a new thought, and a new idea becomes a place of resistance to the world that we see today, a place of renewal, of remembrance, of revolution. That's our responsibility. Don't play small this Thanksgiving. I'm going to invite Danielle to come forward, and not Danielle, Avril. Is Avril in the room? Yeah, come up, and we're going to sing a song to get into. It's a Karen Drucker song. I'm going to invite you to take a deep breath with me. And let this song, its simplicity, its simple lyrics, be an act of rebellion. Let it be an act that says, I won't be in the world. I won't be defined by the world. I'll be in it, but I won't let it define me.
Take a deep breath. I need the band. I knew there was something missing. They just wanted to make sure I was really especially grateful for the music that they play every week. And lest you all forget, it's God. It's God. And it's God. And it's God. Let's put some lyrics up on the screen, please. Thank you for this day, Spirit. This beautiful, beautiful day. Take your hand and put it on your heart. as we get into the song, say, I am so blessed. I am so blessed. Thank you for this day, Spirit. Thank you for this day. Thank you for this day, Spirit. Thank you for this day. This beautiful, day. This beautiful, Thank you for this earth. Thank you for this earth, Spirit. Thank you for this earth. Thank you for this earth, Spirit. Thank you for this earth. This beautiful, this beautiful earth. This beautiful, this beautiful earth, this life. Thank you for this life, Spirit. Thank you for this life. Thank you for this life, Spirit. Thank you for this life. This beautiful, this beautiful life. This beautiful, this beautiful life.
As we prepare to go into meditation, I invite you once again, even though you just did it a moment ago, to take some time. To pause and look around the room again. And as you look around, recognize that each gaze that you meet is a reason for gratitude, just starting right then and there. Then I invite you to adjust your body so that you're sitting tall and well. And now to close your outer eyes. And allow the awareness to move inward into you in this now moment. And now feel your body and feel how it's supported by the chair, just offering gratitude for this gift that gives us ease and comfort. Offer gratitude for your body. Offer gratitude regardless of the age of your body, regardless of illness or health, regardless of the subjective construct of beauty, the body is always working for you. Then moving in a step deeper, letting the body remain in its supported stillness, become aware of your breath. Just for a few moments, notice the breath coming, going, ebbing, and flowing. Offer gratitude for breath. On your next exhalation, release whatever impedes you from gratitude. Inhale with gratitude for another moment of existence. Create a slow, smooth, seamless breath, gratefully sliding into a deeper calm. And as you breathe mindfully, as you let your body continue to be supported and still, you may begin to become aware organically of the stream of thoughts coming and going. Notice the flow of thoughts with gratitude for the mind. As a thought crosses the screen of your mind, regardless of how trivial, regardless of being pleasant or unpleasant, offer gratitude for the mind. Yes, in this now moment, all thoughts are welcome. We aren't trying to shut up the mind. This is your greatest tool. Offering gratitude for the mind and its infinite creativity brings it into one-pointedness. Continuing to let the body remain still, the breath smooth, allowing the thoughts to come and go. Bring your awareness into your heart space. Just let it settle right in that space, offering gratitude for the heart as a muscle and a pump, but then going deeper, offering gratitude to the heart as the seat of your soul. Focus deep into that space and feel that underneath the beats, underneath the brain, underneath the breath and the body is your true nature, which is the one and the same as gratitude. You are gratitude. You are the wow. You are love. You are the silence. The silence. The silence. And let's remain in that space. Observe the silence. It's one and the same as the center of consciousness. Remain aware of that silence just for a moment longer as you notice now the relative quietness of the mind. Remain aware of that silence as you notice how smooth and even the breath has become. Hang on to that silence as you feel one more time the perfect stillness of your body. Bring back the silence as you gently open your eyes and again look around. That silence is in everyone in this space. Namaste.
Thank you, Reverend Averill. Beautiful service. Thank you for that meditation. And now it's time for us to move into offering time. And what a fabulous opportunity to celebrate all that we have. Offering is not just giving. It is choosing to give, but it is also a thankfulness and a gratitude for all of the amazing souls in the space, for all of the amazing souls online, as Reverend Richard said, the people behind the scenes that help to support and make this service and make this place so beautiful. And as our ushers come forward and our prayer box come forward and we prepare our offering, we remember that there are so many ways that we can give. That can be physically in the basket. We can scan the QR code. We can give online. There are so many different ways that we can give, and each way is loved and respected and appreciated. Our prayer box comes forward. We know that these prayers are seen in wholeness and in love and light, and we are thankful to our prayer chaplains for all the work, the silent work that they do to keep us seen in that love and light. So together, let's say our offering blessing. I am so blessed. I am so prosperous. And it is my great pleasure to share of my blessings and to share of my prosperity. And in the giving, the entire world is blessed. Thank you, God. Amen. Please join us.
I am so blessed. I am so blessed. I am so grateful for all that I have. I am so blessed. I am so blessed. I am so grateful. I am so blessed. I am so
grateful that we have a deep bench. Sarah Griffith is fairly new to our community, and you know, we had a singer scheduled for today and she had to cancel, and I went, Sarah, this is you're up to bat. And she didn't hesitate. She has got confidence oozing from her pores. She said she was nervous about singing, and she didn't hesitate to say, I'll step in, I'll pinch hit today. So will you welcome the newest member of our music team, Sarah Griffith.
Kudo. with stopping. Thank you, India.
Wonderful, and welcome to the team. So, an expansive view. Thank you, everything in life. Yes, let's stay up on your feet. Let's close the service here with gratitude for the beautiful music, for the singers, for the grateful stories, the signing, for the chaplains, for the people to your left and your right. Let love guide us to a deeper expansiveness of gratitude. And I thank you, yes, I thank you. For the love you give to me, and I thank you, yes, I thank you, for the love you let me be, and I thank you, yes, I thank you, for the love you give to me, and I thank you, yes, I thank you, for the love.
Have a blessed and wonderful Thanksgiving week. We'll see you next Sunday. The Advent season's getting really close. Have a blessed and beautiful week.